specialized on nomenclature of nomenclature of compounds containing polyfunctional for more than one functional group. Nomenclature of compounds containing more than one functional group. Okay, so if the compound has more than one functional group present, then we have to assign the priority into this. Okay, if the compound has more than one functional group, then one functional group will be primary. The one which has the maximum priority becomes the primary functional group. Primary functional group, and the other one becomes secondary functional. We can have more than one secondary functional group also possible. Right? The suffix in the molecule, if you write, that will be only for the primary functional group. We'll have the suffix of primary functional group, and for secondary functional group, we'll write what? We'll write prefix. Okay? So first of all, you should know the priority order of various functional groups. Then only you can assign the priority, like which one has the maximum priority or minimum priority, and then we can write down the name. So first I'll write down the table, right? Priority order of functional group you write down. Priority order of functional group, we'll write here functional group. This table you drop. This is prefix. And this is suffix. Prefix and suffix. The first one we have COOH. Prefix is carboxylic. And suffix is oic acid.
So why do we need a prefix? What's the most?
Not required. So that will read only when we have it is attached directly to the ring atom. We have over there then carbon dehydrogenate. But carboxylic acid, the prefix is not required basically. The next one we have SO3H. SO3H is sulfonic acid. And prefix is sulfo, suffix is
I'm
Sir, how much is it?
Not much.
So I would argue.
What doubt?
So what if you have anhydride and carboxylic acid? How do you name
it? We take one example.
So could you also tell what the groups are called? Like the
this is carboxylic acid,
yeah.
This is sulfonic acid,
huh.
Anhydride, it is carbonyl chloride.
So, so what second?
Carbonyl chloride also called acid chloride. Acid, if it is X, then acid alides. Okay? Acid chloride, you write down. This one is amide. This is nitrile, isonitrile, this is aldehyde, ketone, alcohol, epoxy alkene alkyne. Achha, anhydride and carboxylic acid we cannot have both because there is no prefix for anhydride.
So then why is it at the third position?
This is the, see, this is the order given by IUPAC. It depends upon the acidic behavior of carboxylic acid. In some book, they have taken SO3H in the first position. So there is a confusion in this.
Okay, so what order are they in?
This is the priority order. Not required. So there is nothing before carboxylic acid. In some book, they have given this on the first position. And this on the second position.
Yes.
They may.
So the fourth one is
acid chloride it is. If it is X then halide.
So the other side
this one carbonyl chloride.
No.
Cyanide is this. CN minus is this one. See here. Group.
No.
You asked the question you're speaking. Cyanide is this. So this carbon can also, this lone pair of carbon has also a tendency to take part in the bonding. And this also takes part in the bonding. So when this is taking part in the bonding, then it is cyanide. When the nitrogen is taking part in the bonding, it is isocyanide. We call it as ambidentate ligand. So this one is ambidentate ligand.
So what's a ligand?
Ligands are electron pair donor. Chlorine is also a kind of ligand. So all those atoms or molecules.
So why it has an expanded?
Because they have more than one site which can donate electron. So carbon can donate electron. Nitrogen can also donate. So ambidentate. Ligands pH is a Lewis
base. Where is this carbon?
He asked what is CN and NC, the difference is only done. See, in this one we have two functional groups, aldehyde and ketone. Which one has higher priority? Aldehyde, right? So we'll have, this one is the primary functional group and this one is secondary functional group. So we'll write the prefix of this and suffix of this. Numbering will start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So it is 5, what is the prefix of ketone? Oxo, right? So 5-oxo hexanal, 5-oxo hexanal, right? Here also, this is the secondary functional group and this is the primary functional group. 1, 2, 3 and 4.
Four
cyanobutanol. Butanol. Butanoic acid. Butanoic acid. Four cyanobutanoic acid.
How does nitrogen still free electrons after using the bond? Shouldn't there be a negative charge on electron?
No, nitrogen, whenever nitrogen is bonded with three bond, like NH3, it has one lone pair on it. So look at this. This is three bond, 1, 2, and 3.
There are three electrons.
1, 2, 3. No, it's bond. And it is one pair of, not three, one pair of. So this is it.
So that's isocyanide.
What is the name of, no, it is cyano.
It's
attached.
Oh, sorry.
What is the name of this compound? This one. See, when you write 4 cyano, it means at the 4th carbon we have cyano group attached.
So
it will be 3 cyano because at third position we have cyano group attached. So we have 3 cyano. Propanoic acid.
That should be. You have to include both functional groups in the name.
Okay. 3 cyano propanoic acid. Because when you write 4 cyano, it is 4 carbon atom and cyano contains 1 more carbon atom, so total 5 carbon should be there, which is not again. So this one we won't count in functional in the parent chain when this is present as the secondary function. Ethanoic, pentanoic, oic acid will use as suffix. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
But that's also C. So we include the C of the functional group.
I'll write the name here.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, third question we have this. So this is substituents now. What is the prefix of this? Carboxylic, right? So it is methyl carboxylic. Right. It is 3 methyl carboxylic, hex 1,6 diol.
Right?
What? 3 methyl carboxylic.
So dioic.
Oh my god. Dioic. 3 methyl carboxylic.
1,6 dioic.
1,6 dioic.
Hexane. 1,6 dioic acid.
So, but shouldn't it be carboxylic methyl because that's the prefix?
No. For, this is the carbon atom which attached with this.
Huh.
So, this is primary and this contains this carboxylic. It should be carboxylic.
Also, carboxylic is methyl, right?
Not methyl. Carboxylic is COH.
Oh, okay.
It is carboxylic methyl.
No, no, no. 10, 15,
25. Methyl is the primary goal. In that we have
seen. How does that usually chuck out 3 power?
So is that C not counted only when it's like in a branch or something?
What?
That's C of the
yes, this one.
Oh, so standing in the part of us, that's not counted.
No, we can count this. But we have larger carbon atom, more carbon.
We said carboxylic
carboxylic.
So do we not count?
No, carboxylic means what? We have one COOH. And it is not ethyl. This is the primary functional group. If you write CH3 here, then what is the answer? If you have CH3, 3 methyl. So it is 3 methyl, but methyl, one of the hydrogen atoms, is substituted by this. So carboxylic methyl. Right, so carboxylic.
So that's only the brass, right? CCOH, which is.
No, CH3COH, we cannot take because the carbon atoms have 5 bonds. See, if you have CH3 here.
No, sir, so I'm saying if this was, if it wasn't coated with this thing, and if it was just CH3COH.
Then it is coming up.
Yeah, so only when it's a branch that the carboxylic part is not taken.
Yes, because the main branch is this one, CH2.
Okay.
And this contains what COOH is. So it is methyl actually, carboxylic methyl.
How are you supposed to know that? Because it has the carboxylic
acid. See, if you take this into the chain, then you should write OH acid. That we cannot write because it's not a parent chain. The primary function, primary branch is this one.
So basically, hydrogen
is
substituted
by COOH. So take the
if you want.
What is the name of this one? 3 cyano 2 methyl 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 Okay, so this is how we do this. When the molecule has more than one functional group, we'll assign the priority. Primary functional group will take suffix and secondary will take prefix. Okay?
Yes, epoxy.
Epoxy ka prefix, because its
position is very low, so it should have to
be. Right, if you want.
Because it will almost never have a suffix.
Yeah, this should be prefix. I have written this
side.
These are all prefix. see this one. This is epoxy, right? 1, 2, 3. What is the name of this one? Here, and second and third question, we have epoxy present. 2, 3 epoxy butane. Right? 2, 3 epoxy butane. For this one, it is 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2 epoxy propane. 1, 2 epoxy propane. 2, 3 epoxy butane. One more thing, all these are prefix, right? I have written here the suffix. For this, we have only prefix of epoxy, E, and I. 2, 3, another like miscellaneous type of example you see. If you have a molecule like this, where oxygen is present in this, in the ring, right? So for oxygen, we'll write oxa. Okay, suppose we have oxygen here. We have sulfur present. We have nitrogen present here.
Only when they're in the ring.
Yeah, in the molecule you see, how many atoms are there in the ring? 6, including this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we'll write oxa for oxygen, cyclohexane. No, it is a miscellaneous compound. We don't take this as a normal rule that we have. Oxa means what? Oxa cyclo means what? You have cyclic ring. And oxa means oxygen is present in the ring. Okay, oxa cyclohexane. Hexane, we have total number of atoms present in the ring, including the carbon and oxygen. If you have sulfur here.
See, I had like an anhydride and a sulfonic thing. So, what would be the final suffix? Like, would I say anhydride?
You won't get anhydride and sulfuric acid in the same compound. You won't get that.
Like, it won't be a question, or is it
any molecule you can write, any combination you can write. But actually, it is not possible. They are very highly acidic compounds. With anhydride, it won't form any bond. Okay, if sulfur is present, then we'll write HIA, THIA. Higher cyclohexane. Higher cyclohexane. Not that important, just you write down this in some cases. If nitrogen is present, then aza cyclohexane. One hydrogen
will be there. So you include the thing itself.
Huh? Like if this is cyclo, it's cyclo including oxygen.
Oxygen, yes. So this term means oxa means oxygen is present in the ring. Thia means sulfur is present in the ring. Aza means nitrogen is present.
Okay. I had can only those things be present in the ring? Is there anything else that can
also? No, you won't get wrong.
So why do you think we have an S and all the other parts? Same thing, we have sulfur in the other corner.
On the other corner, like this. You won't get it. But here you'll get both right. First we'll write higher, then oxa, cyclohexane.
So sulfur has preference over
something.
So then is it O first?
Oxa. Right? Oxa, cyclohexane. But you won't get this kind of thing. If it is there, then you have to write this
too. So it will be 1 oxa, 3 higher cyclohexane.
So look at C1, that will be at the bottom. No, no, 4.
At 4, yeah.
If it is cost,
it's
cost.
So I hear the will be 150 each one.
It's all oxygen.
Yeah.
Oxygen.
Oh, yeah.
We'll write one oxa, four thaya, so like 1, 2, 3, 4. So oxygen.
Oxygen is counted as one.
First, that's why it is hexane.
So like if I had a double bond, right after oxygen.
Yeah.
Okay. So that will be
3. No, it will be 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6.
Okay.
So it's 3 oxa, 6 thaya, cyclohexane. So anything takes preference over oxa. Yes.
So I didn't realize that I didn't finish that question. Say I had an hydride with any group that can be called to a pound. Now you've an hydride with a suffix, but you also one of those things.
Yes. If you have this one in the first, then you write the suffix of this anhydride and prefix of this chloroform.
Okay.
Or haloform.
And so, can you give us examples where keen and I are
triple bond, CH, double bond, triple bond. So here we'll have this as suffix and this is prefix.
So numbering will start from right.
Yes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. If you have CH, 2 double bond CH, COOH. Suffix, prefix. If you have only double bond, that will be prefix because we have only one functional group there. But if you have this functional group and this functional, this is dominant over this.
So this is
suffix over prefix.